Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm DJ Sixsmith. You're watching The Sit Down. Tim Heidecker here with us. Moonbase 8 coming to Showtime. Looks hilarious. Tim, what's up, man? How are you?
I'm doing okay. I'm just backstage at the Tonight Show. About to go on.
I love all the makeshift setups that I've seen.
I know.
You just throw a curtain in and you're good to go.
Every wall is like problematic for different reasons. There's just weird art. It's a mess. But this is the like the most neutral one. But I also feel like I'm on cable access. So it is what it is.
It gets the job done. And yeah. I'll tell you what, people are excited about Moonbase 8, and I'm really excited to check you out in it. What was it like putting this thing together with everybody?
Oh, it was really fun. I mean, I've been friends with John. I've done a lot of work with John C. Reilly, and I've done some stuff with Fred. And we just had this desire to work together, to kind of find a way to sort of cram us all into the same room, literally. And in the show, that's kind of where we find ourselves, is isolated from the rest of the world, out there in the middle of the desert, training to live on the moon. So it was really just this kind of homegrown, homemade project that we did on our own with A24, and luckily found a home at Showtime. But yeah, it's like exactly the kind of show we wanted to make.
That's really cool. And it's interesting also, because when you think about astronauts and people trying to get to the moon, normally they're the best of our society. These guys aren't those people. So what was it like just, you know, showing a different type of astronaut who it's like, hey, this is kind of a middle of the road dude, and we're just trying to figure it out as we go along here?
Well, you know, of course, fundamentally, we want to make something to make you laugh, and that's failure done in the right context is always funny, you know. And we love the Three Stooges and Abbott and Costello and those kind of classic comedy things where you just put very incompetent people in stressful situations that require lots of experience and knowledge and talent and watch them fail, you know. But the other thing that we were interested in was that as the space program kind of becomes more and more normal and more, it's kind of important that it's not just these test pilots that have like this daredevil kind of attitude, that it is going to start requiring sort of regular types to at least be somewhat involved. Now, you know, we take it to the extreme place where these guys really probably do not belong anywhere near the program, but so it's both of those things really.
When did you and John first meet up?
John and I met over 10 years ago. Eric and I, my partner, Eric, were making this cartoon, Tom Goes to the Mayor, on Adult Swim. And John came in to do a voice. And it's just kind of been like a collaboration that's lasted about as long as that. He came back and did this character, Dr. Steve Brule, that you know, many of you may have sent animated GIFs using his face. We've had a blast doing that. And this is sort of the biggest, or I don't know, big, but sort of the most sort of polished thing we've got to do together. And it's just really fun. I talk to him every day. We talk to Fred almost every, you know, we are very close, and it's always fun when you get to work with your friends.
So you've known these guys for a while, but it's another deal to be in this situation where it's, you know, like you said, Three Stooge-esque, Abbott and Costello-esque. Like, what was the coolest thing, or maybe something surprising you didn't anticipate?
I think to get to work with maybe one of the best actors working, John, who can just do anything. And then to work with one of the funniest people I know, in Fred. You know, the thing we were trying to do when we set out is to sort of capture that feeling, that sense of humor that we enjoy privately with each other. We enjoy it between the takes, on set, as you're hanging out, waiting for things to happen. And that's the energy and sort of the spirit we went into making this project with. And we're very proud of the show, but I'm proud that we were able to do it in the way we wanted to do it, kind of on our terms.
So whether it's publicly or privately, you're somebody who's made people laugh for a long time. Who were some of your comedy inspirations when you were first getting going?
Well, this being, you know, Halloween the other day, I showed my kids, I have a 7-year-old and a 4-year-old, I showed them Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein. And was very satisfying to see them laugh in the same way that I laughed when I was a kid at the stupidity of those guys and the physical comedy. But I mean, I throughout my whole life, I've just loved comedy, and whether it was Saturday Night Live with Phil Hartman and Dana Carvey, Dan Aykroyd too, I guess. But
we'll throw him in there too. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you know, SCTV, Andy Kaufman, Albert Brooks. I ate it all up, and you know, Spinal Tap. You know, just so many things that influenced early Simpsons. All of it.
All the good stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I have good comedy taste usually.
I would say so. Do your kids have good comedy taste? Do they think their dad's funny, or they're not there yet with that?
They do think I'm kind of funny. I'm kind of like I'm the oldest brother in the family. Like the problem with showing them slapstick like Abbott and Costello and the Three Stooges is they now use that on me, where they slap me on the head and slap me across the face and kick my daughter's doing this thing where she kicks me in the shins. And it really is funny, but she's doing it as like a joke, but it's like, it's like, so we have that thing going, and you know, you have to kind of like control it a little bit. But yeah, I think they're very funny, and I think they think they understand that I'm trying to be funny.
Well, that's good news. I'm glad to hear that. So you've done some cool stuff in your career. How about Bridesmaids? What do you remember from doing that one?
I remember feeling like, what am I doing here? Because it was a huge movie. It was just, you know, seeing the catering, just the catering alone was like the budget of our TV show, you know. But Maya Rudolph was so nice. And Kristen Wiig was so nice. Everybody was super nice. And Maya and I ended up having a lot of scenes together because I was getting married to her. And we were just cracking each other up. And it felt very natural, very same kind of thing I have with Fred or other kind of funny people, is you just kind of end up doing bits. And I was just kind of trying to, you know, not embarrass myself. It's one thing where you, like, I do a lot of stuff, and there's a lot of stuff I do that my parents can show their friends or can't show their friends, I should say. And that's one where they can go, oh, my son, I saw your son in Bridesmaids. And they can call their parents, they can call their friends, or their friends can call them and stuff. So nice to have that.
Yeah, not exactly the Adult Swim audience there with your parents' generation. A little bit different.
A little different.
So when people check out Moonbase 8, what are some big things you want them to be thinking about? Or just, you know, as they hang out and enjoy it with their family, what do you want them to be thinking about?
Well, first of all, I feel like it's a nice reprieve from the world that we're living through right now. I think it's a new, you know, with every new thing I do with other people, it's always takes a second to find your footing about what the tone of this is and what's funny about it and everything. I think the show gets kind of funnier as it goes along, not only because, I don't know, that just sort of is what happens in the way you make things, but you know, jokes start sort of compounding on themselves. And the more you know the characters, I think the funnier the show becomes. So it's meant to be just like a fun, a fun show to watch. And it looks great and everybody's really good in it. So I just hope it's a nice break from the world.
We need that right about now. Tim, really nice to meet you, man. Thanks so much for jumping on, and I look forward to watching it.
Thank you. Take care.